In order to control the robot, the default application called Conti can be used. It can be installed on any Android device. When we open up the app, we can see three different options. We have Local Connect, which makes us able to practice with Conti without connecting to the actual robot. We have Wi-Fi Connect, with which we can connect to the robot wirelessly. And we have USB Connect, which we can use to a USB port to connect to the robot. For the first time use, let's connect to the robot via USB cable. First, we need to make some changes to our device to be able to connect to the robot. Go to About Tablet and press Build Number a few times, so you'll become a developer. I will turn it on again on here, and then we can plug on USB debugging to be able to connect to the robot. When we open the Conti app again and press USB Connect, you'll be able to make a connection to the robot. We'll choose not to load the default program. We're now in the main menu of Conti. I will explain the menu a little bit, but first let's take note of the IP address so we can connect to the robot wirelessly. Under Option and Application Information, you'll find the IP address. If you write it down, you can go back to the main menu and connect now to the IP address that's stated over there. Now we can loose the cable. In the main menu, we can see how the robot is positioned, as well as seeing the joint angles and the coordinates of the end of the robot. There's also 9 different sub-menus, which we can use to control the robot. First of all, we can go back to the start screen with the main button. We can look at different options of the robot with the option button.
At view rotation option, it's possible to change the viewpoint rotation of the robot model in Conti. Often, most convenient is the default set axis, which gain tuning, the control gains and collision detection threshold of the internal motion controller can be set. Manual tuning is only for service engineers. Automatic tuning can be used to let the robot itself decide the collision detection values for your program. With initialization, the collision detection values are reset to their default value. At the language tab, it's possible to switch the language used in Conti. With same home position, a new home position can be set. The home position of the robot is usually used as the starting or ending position of a task, or it is the position where the robot returns when an error occurs. Screen lock lets you edit the lock screen settings of Conti. By default, it locks the screen after a certain amount of time to prevent from unintentional user input. Application information shows the information of the product in use, including the software versions of the robot in Conti, as well as the robot's IP address. With reboot, the robot can be rebooted. Lastly, check motor state to place information on the current status and error code of each joint motor.
We can navigate to different views of the robot with the view button. With beginner and advanced mode, we can change between the different modes. With the program button, we can start a new program or load another one. Here are some other settings of the robot we can change.
At servo/smart.io, it's possible to monitor and switch on or off the motors and digital inputs and outputs of the control box. With robot mounting angle, the mounting angle of the robot can be adjusted. This is needed when the robot is installed on a wall or ceiling or any other object not perpendicular to the ground. In the properties window, it's possible to set the default velocity and blending values of motion commands. Next to this, it's possible to set the mass and the center of mass of a tool mounted at the end of the robot arm. Collision detection sets the collision detection level. Smart.io map displays the various input and output ports positions on the back panel of the control box. At tool center point, the center point of an attached tool can be specified. Next, at the tool window, different tool operations for attached tools can be linked to input and output signals. Reference frame can be used to change the default reference frame used by frame movements. By default, this is originated at the base of the robot. At pallet, a pallet can be defined, used for palletizing tasks. With starting configuration, the default startup settings can be changed. At DIO configuration, it's possible to set the function for each digital input and output signal of the control box, so that you control the robot or receive the status of the robot using a digital input or output signal. Finally, at the end tool port window, a on or off signal can be sent to an attached tool.
We can move the robot to two defined start positions.
Pressing the lock button will show all messages generated during operation of the robot. When the robot runs into a problem, the errors will show here.
We can view the lock of the robot or use the reset button if the robot stopped due to any safety functions. And finally, we can lock or unlock the screen if desired.